You dinked, but there's nobody there.
Hang on. There's a reason.
Oh. All right. They're there.
They're there.
Well, they're there. We're here.
Yes.
Only the video camera is not turned on yet because Google is once again playing with us. Apparently, GeoGearheads had problems last night, too. Yeah. So I'm just making sure other things are up and in set and that we are at least broadcasting, which should show up momentarily to the fine folks out in the real world. And we will make sure that's going. Yeah. And then I will turn the camera on and hopefully things will work. And go from there.
They hear us.
They do hear us.
But okay. They do not see us.
They do not see us. They just
see
a picture of moi.
I'm sorry for all the people out there.
Yes, so I'm going to. Yes, it is traumatic as it is.
It is very traumatic. Don't let the young children look.
Yes, we have some of the.
Oh, best. I should put on my headphones.
Yeah, that would be good. Can you hear things with that?
I can hear you just fine because you're sitting next to me.
All right, look at that.
Oh my gosh, there we are.
Yay.
Look at us.
That's us and all our wonderfulness. All right. Let me make sure I've got a couple things going here.
We got a couple
things. This is set. We got things going. Let me see if I get the pre-show logo up and that should be up and working. And that's
look at
good.
That.
Hey.
Oh, I hear you still.
You hear me still?
Yes.
That's good. All right. We nice. Seem to be recording okay. Hey, folks. Welcome, welcome, welcome to GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast pre-show. Yes, we had a couple of interesting...
Yes, I am your conscience. Conscience.
Who was the one that Barry White did? This is your appetite speaking and just slow music. And then I think it was like for Arby's or something. So, yeah.
I don't know.
Okay. She's there. Amy is our conscience. Yes.
Yeah. They said you need to add Amy to the picture.
You are there. You're there. This is
no,
us.
The one that they see. The one.
Oh, that one. That's been there forever.
Yes.
And I should have you put on there.
You need to update it.
Like we never have our pictures.
That was
together.
BA.
That was BA. All right. Yes. Before Amy.
Yes.
Yes, it certainly was. Memories. Bad. So, hey, welcome, welcome, folks. Yeah, we had a little bit of a problem. Google Plus Hangouts, the favorite thing it likes to do is everything. The camera works fine. Actually, we seem to be in exceptionally good focus tonight.
Why do you have to reconnect over there?
I don't know. I'll reconnect this and see what happens. That should work just peachy keen. I think what happened is there's a new thing that Shantango does that if you don't move for like 20 minutes.
I've never seen that.
It does now for mine. I noticed it last night when I did Geocaching podcast.
Oh, that's going to.
Yeah. So anyways.
I need to write them.
So anyways, what will happen is. Everything will be normal. We're doing our normal setup. Everything's ready to go. We're just ready to hit broadcast. And we hit broadcast. And then it locks. The whole thing locks. And
we says, nope.
We have no idea why it's doing it. I think it has something to do with the camera. Because. Yes, it is so much better. I have to say.
WA is much better.
Yes, with Amy is so much better. The correct answer is. Oh,
that is awesome.
So, yeah, it's one of those things. So, anyways, the screen locks, and then I got to reboot it and go the rest of it. And I've been trying to do different things to see to keep it from doing this. And apparently a lot of other podcasts have been having the same problem, and they're actually talking potentially of jumping ship. To what? Something else.
What?
Some other kind of media format to go through. I'm going to stick with this because it's free.
I like free.
Free's good. So as long as that works with that. But there's
free is great.
There's another one that I've got to look
but
into.
But free has its
price.
Secrecy.
Ooh, that's a big word.
Is that
like serendipity?
Sure.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, it has its quirks.
It has.
That's easier to say.
It does. It does indeed.
Yeah.
So yeah, good stuff. We had some fun.
As long
fun.
As you can fix them, I'm good.
I try my best. Yeah. I keep pulling that hat out of the rabbit, and the way it goes.
Oh, that's got to be a hurt.
They squeal.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. But yeah, lots of good stuff. We actually went out. The temperature.
We actually went geocaching. Yay. Can you believe it? The temperature was not fry your brain hot.
Yes.
So we actually got a chance to go out.
Yeah, last weekend it was awesome. Gorgeous. It was like 76 because it is just so wonderful. It was so nice. We had just beautiful. The weather was sparkling. It really was. It was one of those things.
It was sparkling. I missed that.
We could breathe.
Yeah, yes.
And not have our lungs implode. Uh-huh. And it was nice out. So we went out geocaching.
Yeah, it was really nice.
And found a few geocaches, kind of a little.
Played around in a little
mini series that we went for. And we actually got 2 out of 3 of that series.
Played around in a magnolia tree.
Played around in magnolia's trees and found out that it wasn't there.
Yeah, tried to find a cache there.
Yeah, but the other ones we found.
Yeah.
And that was fun. And then we found an interesting note.
Oh, we cannot say that here.
No, we're not going to because we're a family-oriented
show.
But we found an interesting note from, I don't know if it was a geocacher or a muggle or somebody.
I don't really know, but it was interesting. I was hey, this is educational. He said, what is it? And I read it to him. He said, oh, I got to take a picture of that.
Yes, and I did. And, of course, I put it on the social media. So if you've got us in Facebook or Google+, you can check out from Saturday, I believe it was, the note that I had. We had found, and it was interesting. It was kind of a not necessarily a threatening warning, but just a
no. Hey, it was hey, did you know?
Did you know?
Yeah, and we were like, no, I would not have guessed that out here in the middle of a parking lot,
the far end of a parking lot.
But hey, whatever floats your boat.
There was much and many of what it was.
Yeah.
And it was stated that there was much and many of what it was. So, yes, check out the check out Facebook and Google+.
Dig up everybody's curiosity.
As we go that way.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
It was funny.
You don't usually get notes like that in the
Yeah, and it was kind of written long. It was kind of a long blurb there.
Yeah. It really was.
Yeah, it was like a paragraph.
Yes.
As much as it can be on the log.
Yes, that you can get out of a bison tube-sized log. So
yeah,
pretty cool.
It was funny.
Anyways, good stuff. Yeah. Had a good time. It was just nice being out.
Yeah,
and having the weather to go with that. So we're kind of looking forward to it. And it looks like somebody actually turned off the summer switch because now I'm not going to jinx myself, but right now the temps are in the low 80s.
It's supposed to be 85, I think.
Yeah, it's supposed to warm up the next couple days and then dips back down.
I have a meeting Saturday morning, so we can't go out early Saturday morning.
Oh, you have a meeting?
Yeah, it's from like 8 to 9 or something.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, really, it's your sleeping time, so it's not going to disturb you.
I'll be fine.
Yes, I think you will.
So yeah. Anyways, good time. It's just good to be out and finding some geocaches and just getting out there and having some fun. So we hope you guys did too. It was neat. Lots of good stuff. We have. By the way, if you're new, welcome to the Patron Pre-Show. If you've been here before, welcome to the Patron Pre-Show. For the folks that are new, what's going on is this is the show before the show. We just kind of. It's kind of like a meet and greet kind of talk. We got a lot of people in the chat room. We've got people talking to this and, you know, and then there's us. And so we just
show up and turn everything on so you guys can talk.
Hopefully. That's pretty much it. We're just in the background.
Yeah, I mean, and he fixes it if we can't.
So. Yeah, we try.
I just show up with my cider and my water.
No coffee?
No, tonight's a cider night. I didn't want the coffee.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Wasn't feeling it.
That's impressive.
Just wasn't feeling it.
That's how it goes.
Because you got the creamer that has the calories and you got the... Yeah. And I'm like, just don't feel it.
Yeah. Well, after being on the treadmill, the last thing you want to do is throw on that extra 2 calories
and I know
of
that the,
creamer.
Well, I'm trying, man.
All right. Hey, whatever works.
Plus the the caffeine. I'm trying to cut back on my caffeine.
Ah, now see, that's different.
Yeah, I am trying to cut back on my caffeine.
Yeah, that's so, that could be dangerous.
Yeah.
For me. Just saying.
No, because I wanna see if I can start sleeping better at night.
Ah. Huh? A bomb can go off and you don't go.
I know, but I'm actually waking up at night, and I don't wanna wake up at night. I wanna sleep all the way through the night.
You're talking to Mr. Runs laps at night.
I know, but I don't.
No, you
I shouldn't. So you I have no reason out. To. Yeah. So I wanna stop.
You want to sleep that. Deeper.
I want to sleep all the way through the night.
I would kill for 4 hours of good sleep.
I know you would. I know you would. I'm just so saying. That's why I don't even tell you.
Yeah.
I don't even talk about it.
That's how it goes. So yeah. Anyways, this is it. This is kind of like a meet and greet. You get to hear all the weird, strange stuff that we do each and every week. Like.
And our sleep habits.
Sleeping Beauty, sleep apnea. I'm just saying.
You don't have sleep apnea. Well, oh, please. But, your problem is your restless leg, so
yes. Whatever. Yeah, that's no fun. But, yeah, that's how it goes. But yeah.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
I have an announcement now.
Uh-oh.
I did not until just now.
Uh-huh.
But I have to make a very, very important announcement.
Am I coming out of the closet?
I don't know. That's your thing.
Oh, I was just curious.
No, that's your thing. If you want to, that's fine.
It's a great dark room.
Yeah. Today.
Uh-huh.
September 17th.
Yes. 2015.
Yes. Is Doc Gurney's birthday.
Really?
Yes.
Well, absolutely happy birthday to Doc Gurney's. That's awesome. Good stuff. Happy birthday.
Yes. Birthdays are great.
Birthdays are awesome.
Birthdays are important.
Somebody in the chat room put up a birthday cake, and Doc Gurney can digitally blow them out. I'm just saying. Congratulations. That's awesome.
Yes.
Good stuff.
So happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
I won't sing. That can be your birthday present.
Thank you. Mine too.
Yes.
As all of you.
Yes.
So yeah. But anyways, that's the pre-show. We just kind of talk about stuff. We have got so much stuff.
Do we?
Coming up in the next couple of months. It is going to literally.
Oh, in the months. Yeah, I don't. Yeah.
Blow your minds. We have been talking with all the sponsors, and we've been getting them involved with some serious stuff. So since you here are in the pre-show, get all the stuff before everybody else, you can know this. We've got a sponsor confirmed for all of October. So we're going to do a month-long promotion for them. We've got another sponsor for all of November, and we're waiting for the finalization for the last sponsor for December, month-long programs. So in other words, contests, goodies, swag, geocoins.
Can I win?
No. Sorry. Oh, not sad, Amy. Yes, this is for all you fine folks. We are going to have stuff.
But I like stuff. On I like stuff. Coins.
Yes, I know you do.
What's Aaron's number? I need to talk to Aaron.
He actually just sent us a ton of stuff. No, you can't have any. Sorry.
Where is it?
It's not here yet.
It is here.
No, it's not here.
It is here.
It's not here here.
No.
No, it is not here here.
It's somewhere in this house.
So anyways, we have all sorts of stuff starting in the next couple of weeks that are going to blow you away. You are so much going to want to be a patron, and you are so much going to be here for the live broadcasts if you can. And then there's stuff everywhere. We got tons of stuff. So, yeah. Lots of stuff, good stuff, and you are going to just absolutely love all the things that we're going to have.
Keep telling me that, and I'm going to go find it now.
It is good. We got about 6 more minutes before we start the show. And so do you want to see that little birdie got out again and gave away what we are going to be giving away tonight
live? Do I have one already?
On the show, yes. You actually have this one.
Good.
This one you actually do have. You want to see?
Yes.
We will show you. I will take it out of the package and put it in front of the camera lens of which you can see because it's all nicely wrapped up.
Yeah.
All right. So this is an awesome Sherpa coin. This is a Sherpa coin that's actually in three pieces. And I have, after we give this one away tonight, I got one left. That's it.
That's it?
That is it. We have given them away. And as far as I can tell right now, you can't get these anymore. These are gorgeous. So this is what we're giving away tonight. This is the Eye of the Dragon geocoin from gxproxy.com. This is gorgeous. The actual dragon, which is the piece just above the path coin. The path coin's the little green circle in the bottom. The dragon is magnetic. That comes off.
Let me take it off.
And then there's the actual main coin. Look how thick this is. This is like a piece of art. There's the back.
Dragons.
All right, I'll let you look at it for a minute. But that is going to go to some lucky winner tonight live on the show.
Here's the dragon.
Okay. Well, you have to kind of move it forward short length.
That's my arm.
Okay.
That's all I got.
And then you have the path tag.
Yeah, that I can never get off. Uh-huh. There we go.
You've got 6-inch nails and you can't get a path tag out.
I don't have 6-inch nails.
So
I can't get the thing off.
Yeah, it's
see?
No, that's smart. I got it right here.
Smart Alec.
I am a smart Alec. Uh-huh. I just need to press it enough. From a different angle. There you go. That's what I wanted. Okay, show the path tag. And this is a beautiful exclusive path tag that comes with the coin. And then you have the coin itself. And you can see the magnet at the bottom. It's beautiful. It's this one has like a bronze and silver.
Can y'all actually see the path tag?
Yeah. Huh?
I said, can they actually see the path tag from this way distance behind?
That's what the path tag looks like.
Yeah, because you got those orangutan arms.
Not me. That's why they call me Stumpy. Anyways, this is how
funny
this
boy.
Is. So this fits into the, because it's a Sherpa coin.
I show the dragon.
And then I will put this aligned as it's supposed to be.
Show the
dragon. And then this piece is the head of the dragon.
Yeah, that's cool.
Which is also hooks onto this magnetically, and it fits as three pieces, and it kind of clicks in just like that. And there you go. This is gorgeous. I have seen these go on eBay for as much as $200. I'm not kidding. You cannot get them anymore through GX Proxy. So unless they reprint, which I have not heard of, this is it. You can't get them. I got one left after this. So that's the prize that we're giving away tonight. Care of the little birdie that likes giving away all our secrets. Spread out on a couple of the social webs there. That how it got my account, I have no knowledge how that worked. But
you tell it.
You know, I talk in my sleep when I do sleep.
Actually, you do.
In between the snoring.
Actually, you do.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Doesn't seem like it.
That's how I learn stuff.
Great. And not only do you get that, you also get the proxy coin that comes along with it. So these are like gorgeous stuff. So that's the prize we're giving away tonight live. And the other one will be we're giving away the How to Puzzle Cache book. From Cully Long.
Yes. One of the viewers already got his.
Awesome.
He ordered it and one of them.
Yep.
One of the ones that ordered it already.
Yep. So we're going to be giving that away as our weekly prize for this week.
Yeah. That coin is absolutely beautiful. It is truly a work of art.
Yeah. And like I said, I have seen them as much as $200 on eBay.
Oh, that's crazy.
Just saying, giving it away free to you fine folks. So we hope you enjoy it. Yep, it is gorgeous.
Well, one person.
Yeah. Yes, one person. I'm glad you clarified that. Just saying.
Sorry.
All right. Well, we got about
another minute. See, it's great. W-A.
I would be completely lost without you, my dear.
I know.
I mean, worse than I already am. I'm just saying. Yes. See, I'm trying to be nice. And I haven't even had coffee, or neither has she. So that I'm just
telling. Not since this morning.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Awesome.
Yep. So the books, we'll give that out too. And good stuff. It's a really good read if you haven't. If not, check out a couple episodes back with How to Puzzle Cache with Cully Long. And that was awesome. That was just a fun episode.
Mm-hmm. It was.
All right. Good stuff. Yeah, we got a lot to do tonight. This is going to be busy. So it's going on 8:30, mm-hmm. and we are just about ready to start. I'm going to get things going here, and I think we're about there.
Are we?
I think so. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
I think ready I'm ready.
As I'm ever going to be.
All right. So, folks, sit back, relax, get your favorite libation, your favorite snack, the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast.
You won't let me have a snack.
Not while you're doing the show. You ever hear somebody going, it's just terrible. It does not make well for video and or audio listening. I'm just saying. And now I want a sandwich. Sit back, relax, get your favorite snack, your favorite libation. The GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast is coming at you. Oh, right about now. Welcome to the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast. I'm your host, Andy HeadHardHat Smith, and I am here with the wonderful, the delightful, the DeWitty, WA?
Yes.
With Amy, the HeadHardHatress. Welcome to the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast. Let's see. It is September 17th, 2015. In the next hour or so, both co-host Amy the HeadHardHatress and I will bring you some interesting information and tidbits about the game, the sport, yes, the obsession known as geocaching. Do I want to know? Yes? What? Am I getting the impression that little bird got a little higher audience participation tonight?
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking.
Somebody said if they wanted to listen to you talk, they'd just hang out at the Geocaching Podcast.
Yes, that also is a fun show to listen to.
Is it now?
Yes. Matter of fact, Mark Downing.
Can you refresh me over there, please?
He went through and let's see if I click reconnect, if it just does it. There we go.
Awesome.
He actually was talking about Audible books. And how he's going through. Mark, by the way, is the host of the OB Geocaching yes. podcast. And he said something to the effect of...
He's not the one listening.
Wouldn't it be interesting, because he goes through so many books, Audible books.
Yeah.
He said, wouldn't it be interesting if HeadHardHat could read some Audible books? And I went, oh, that would not be good.
If you one, could read some?
You could either, I will just jitter through it like I do normally through the show,
uh-huh.
or it's going to be like a Unisom convention and yes, everybody's I'm just like, going to be,
why would you do that?
And they're gone. So I'm just, I am just saying.
Oh, the, thank God something I can sleep
with. I love where some friends of mine will sit there and say about, yes, listening to the quiet doldrums of HeadHardHat as he talks through the podcast.
I'll read one.
Oh, yeah, that would be interesting, y'all. Read a French book and Southern.
I could read it like this.
Oh, see, then I'm going to be having issues.
I can't help that.
You have sexy voice.
I've been told that.
See, I've got car dealer voice.
Yeah, you really do.
Yeah, so that's.
I don't want to totally listen to you read a book. I love you, but no.
I can't even do it right now. We got to move on. Anyways.
Well, hello. Yeah. Uh-uh. No, I don't want
to
do that.
She said to him. Anyways, welcome to the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast, folks. This is going to be a lot of fun. Got a really good show for you. This week, we had some fun. We actually got to go out geocaching. That's right. We actually got to go out into the atmosphere of outdoors without having problems of molten lava, exploding bugs, or having your sneakers melt to the concrete. It was nice. It was like mid-70s, and we got to go out and go geocaching. And
yeah, it was good time. Awesome.
It was like breathable.
Yeah.
So we actually went out and went geocaching. So that was a lot Woo-hoo! Of fun. Yeah. Had a good time, found some interesting Woo-hoo. Things, found an interesting geocaching log that had some interesting verbiage in a slight, well, just a little bit of interest upon the point of interest of which we found it. And we're not going to go into it too much because this is a family-friendly show.
Yeah, it was funny.
And but if you go see our Facebook, look around Saturday or so for Facebook from our entries, and for either that or Google Plus, and you'll find said note. And it brought up some interesting topics.
Educational.
The people out in the geocaching world responded back and talked about it, and it was a good thing. So
I did not.
Lots of good stuff to get into.
I did not.
Yeah. So anyways, good weekend geocaching, which is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully we can go again this weekend.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Because the weather actually is, it's now, the trend is going to be like mid-80s down now. So, mm-hmm. and pretty soon people are going to be saying, it's still cold out. And we're like, yeah, this is good. This is why we moved to North Kakalaki. Not to get four months of oven.
I didn't move here.
No, but I did.
I was born here.
Yeah, but to have all the nice.
I'm a native.
If you couldn't tell. So, yeah, that was good.
He's the Yankee.
Yes, I am. Anywho, a good Yankee. Let's see. What else can we go over here since I'm getting.
Before this digresses.
So, while this goes right down the spiraling vent of life. So you say to yourself, why you say this, I have no idea, but you say to yourself, so how can you watch the show live or generally get in touch with Amy and Andy? Because, hey, they are so much fun to communicate with. And we are. We're pretty cool. It is.
Oh, you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's all right.
Did you see that?
Yeah, you said it out loud.
Oh, man.
You can watch the live feed or join us in the chat room by going to www.geosnippets.com.
See, I made coffee.
States at 8:30 p.m. Eastern time, and I told you that. We also have all our social media links. So if you go to geosnippets.com, geosnippetsreboot.com, any of my blog, if you go up, there is the social networks that you can click on where for Amy and myself and for the show, and just click into that. The two main things that you want to do is you want to have us in your your Google Plus circles. So that way when we do different requests for geocachers about, hey, what do you think about this, or what's your thoughts about that, or our polls, or any of that stuff, you automatically get into that. The second one is with, excuse me, our YouTube channel. Please hook into that, because that way every time we do a podcast, every time we do a vlog, all that comes out. And goes right into your subscription box. You don't have to go looking for it. It's right there waiting for you with our happy little faces. And you can get right into that. So please make sure you get us hooked up into any of your social media networks, including Periscope. Start doing that, because we have a lot of fun with that now, going out every once in a while and just
I've done one.
Throwing.
I haven't done another one.
You got to learn. It's going to come.
I actually did that one pretty good.
You did quite well. You did not talk like this. This no, was very like I would, good.
Yeah, like I did the first video I did. I was like.
So, yeah, check out Periscope.
I was being held hostage or something.
Yep, that goes through Twitter. Hook up with that, because we do a lot of spontaneous stuff as well. Like, I've seen a lot of people with geocaching, actually.
I started to pull off on the side of the road when I was in traffic today and just do a Periscope.
That would have been educational.
When it is like, hey, I'm stuck in traffic. Here it is.
Let's talk.
Let's talk. What you got?
Awesome. Finally, we have our voicemail line where you can call in your comments, your questions, your suggestions by calling 919-341-9519. Or you don't even have to worry about that. Just go to geosnippets.com or geosnippetsreboot.com. Right side of the screen is our send voicemail tab. Just click onto that and you can talk for up to 3 minutes. And just tell us everything that you'd like us to know that's geocaching related, milestones, things that you'd like to see more of the show, less of the show, anything that's constructive, let us know. And if deemed worthy, we will put it in our viewer feedback. The nice thing about all that is it's free. By all means, make sure that you give it a try. Now, Amy, we actually have two bits of viewer feedback tonight. And I will let you read the first part here. And this is the first time we've heard from this person. And
really?
I thought you would do a fine job reading this.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Oh, wow. That's an interesting name.
Yep.
It says, hi, my caching name is Geopudge. I like that name. I listen to the podcast quite frequently. Thank you. You guys do a great job. I'll take credit. I recently hit my 100th find. Woohoo! Whoop whoop. I have enjoyed the journey thus far and will continue to. I also want to share the story of my very first geocache find. The first cache I found has since been archived. I don't remember exactly how I learned about geocaching, but I remember watching a bunch of the geocaching vloggers' videos.
Yay, Josh.
He is awesome. Having all of my experience based on those videos, my first find was much harder than it should have been. It was around a billboard near a brick wall. I searched for a while along the wall, thinking it was hidden behind a brick or something. Eventually, I discovered a camo magnetic pill bottle about 8 feet up on a metal leg of the billboard. Inside, I found a log, but also a business card from a local assisted living home. The back of the card instructed me to take it to the home for a sweet treat. So I took it in and met a fellow cashier and received a mug that had been turned into a candy bar bouquet.
Oh, cool.
This experience was the catalyst of my love for the game, sport, and yes, the obsession known as geocaching. Geopudge.
That was awesome. Yeah, you know, you never know.
That is amazing.
That is, you know, a lot of times for people, that's called first to find prizes.
Yeah.
It's things like that. And just what a great way to communicate with people.
Yes.
That is awesome. Good stuff. Well, we also have, and thank you, GeoPudge, for sending that in. We also have a Joshua update.
Joshua,
the geocaching vlogger.
Yes.
Update via SpeakPipe. And we're going to write that out right about here. Let me put that now.
Hello, Andy and Amy. It is Joshua, the geocaching vlogger. I am calling in because it's been a few weeks since I have called in the show, and I thought it'd be fun to give you a little update. And also, I have a little announcement sort of reminder that I thought I would share too. First of all, I just want to take a moment to thank you for your podcast. As you know, that I am training for my very first marathon, and it's getting to the point where the mileage is getting really, really high. And this weekend, I actually ran the longest I have ever done in my life, and that was 18 miles.
Wow.
It took me over 3 hours to do. It was pretty intense. I had a lot of pain in my legs, but I would not have been able to do it without your podcast, because your podcast distracted my mind, distracted the pain that I was feeling in my legs in mile 15 and 16 and 17 and 18. So thanks so much for the distraction, the awesome geocaching distraction as I was running that race. And I'm getting close. I'm getting close to be able to run the 26.2 miles. So thanks for that. Also, I wanted to mention something that I have not heard on any of the geocaching podcasts. I don't know if it got missed or whatever, but I assume you know that the geocaching.com headquarters is allowing those that want to host their own Geocaching International Film Festival, with the 16 finalist videos. Maybe you did or didn't know this, but the Geocaching International Film Festival that was supposed to be at the block party was actually canceled because of rain. So geocaching.com had this brilliant idea of allowing those that could find a screen and a sound system to be able to host their own International Geocaching Festival event. So we're having one in Minneapolis. I'm excited about this. Geocaching Film Festival stuff is something that's important to me. So I just thought your listeners would like to be reminded and know that they can host their own, and that would be amazing. So that's what I got. Just a little thank you for the distraction of geocaching podcast goodness, and also just to let your listeners know that they can have their own Geocaching International Film Festival, and geocaching.com will give them the video files to be able to show to a group of people. All right, guys. Hope you have a great week. Love your faces. Talk to you soon. Josh out.
Oh, thank you, Joshua. Man, he is awesome. We love Joshua. He's
Josh,
such a cool
I am
guy.
so proud of you
yes,
for doing this.
That is awesome. Man, that
I
is,
am so pulling for you.
Yeah, keep it
you
up, buddy.
Awesome.
That's great.
Keep going.
Now, just so that you know, Joshua is, as far as I'm concerned, the king of geocaching vlogging. He goes out at least once a month and puts out different videos that for geocaching, actually several times a month in some cases. I know he's also referenced to it sometimes as his other full-time job. So that lets you know how much mm-hmm. he goes out and makes these amazing videos.
Now, he's also on Periscope.
Yes, he does a lot of stuff on Periscope.
And I love watching him on Periscope.
Yeah.
Him and others too, because a lot of people will say, I could never do live broadcasting. And it cracks me up because obviously we do it every week. And we mess it up every week.
Yes.
And people say, oh, I can never do that. You know.
Oh, just go out and have fun.
You just go out and have fun. And he said, and I'm going to call him out on this. Sorry, Joshua. But hopefully I'm proud of you will make up for it. He was doing Munzee. He had a Munzee. And apparently he had Muggle on his mind because he called it a Muggy. And
it's embarrassing for those type of people that mix up words. It's really something.
I just busted out.
I
laughing.
Don't understand.
I'm like, dude, I totally know where you're at.
But yeah, it's good stuff. Anyways, you can see Joshua. We're gonna have in our show notes how to get to his main YouTube page, and also we're gonna have just below that is how to host your own Geocaching International Film Festival event. This comes straight out of the geocaching blog, so we'll have a link to that as well. Literally gives all the step-by-step instructions on how to set up a GIFF event. So go try that. Check out the link in our show notes. That'll be in episode 129 of the GeoSnippitsReboot.com. Go there and you can get all the show notes tonight after we finish broadcasting. All right, other good stuff. Our GeoSnippets Reboot Podcast Geocaching Poll of the Week. We put out a poll each week through Google+, and we get a ton of people calling in and letting us know what they think about different geocaching subjects. The one this week was interesting. How long have you been geocaching? How long have you been geocaching? And I'm going to bring it up live right here. And wife Amy, if you would be so kind from going lowest to highest, I thought the results were rather interesting.
Hey, I was there.
Oh, with the picture? Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry, got sidetracked. Yeah, I'm like, hey, wait a minute. I was there. I don't think I was in the picture. Anyway, sorry. I was wearing Wolverine that day. I was looking for tie-dye.
We digress.
Anyway, okay, 0%, less than 1 year.
Which I find completely blows me out of the water, but keep going.
Okay, I have an idea.
Okay.
About that. At 8%, greater than 10 years.
All right.
12%, 1 to 2 years.
Okay.
23%, 3 to 4 years. And at 58%, 5 to 10 years.
Yeah. That's awesome. So what this tells me, now let me see what your idea is with this.
No, go ahead.
What this tells me is that the majority of geocachers that are hooked into the interwebs as Google Plus in this particular case, are the more experienced cachers, the more advanced cachers, which leaves a huge hole of people that are just starting out that don't know about the GeoSnippits Reboot podcast. And I find that disturbing. We have to have a way of having it so that people can let these fine folks know how to get a hold of us so they can get into these polls and let us know what's going on and have their viewpoints of geocaching. That's how I look at it. What were you thinking?
I'm thinking that they either that one of two things has happened. Either one, they don't know about us.
Right.
Two, they read it and just didn't vote.
Well, that's not any good.
I'm just saying it's a possibility.
You can't tell your viewpoint if you don't put it in.
Correct.
But that is a good thing,
but
you know.
You have to think about that.
So does that mean the behavior of the newer geocachers with their quick
instant gratification
doesn't take the time? Like they said, I didn't read the article. I glanced over the article.
See?
That
my
kind
point
of,
exactly.
That kind of mentality. Wow. Interesting discussion. We'll have to work on this up at a mishmash show or something sometime. So anyways, good results with that.
We actually analyzed a Doctor Who show yesterday.
It was interesting. But that's a whole other digression, and we're not getting into Doctor Who's right now. Uh-oh, what's up?
We froze.
Let's see. I don't know why. We're still live.
Everybody froze.
All right. Well, we're going to keep going. Can they hear us? Because we're going live right now.
Okay.
What I would suggest is refresh your...
Okay, we're back.
Yeah, refresh your stuff. Okay, that's a Google thing. Right now, we've been smooth through this whole time. So
yeah.
I don't know what that is. We'll have to check Google Plus when it comes out on the other end. But anyways, that's how that goes. Yes, Google Plus. Thank you so much. Anyway, so that's how that goes. Let's move on to, there were two people in the polls that did say that they were coming up on their 10th anniversary. One was Joe Moran, and the other one was Scott Garand. I hope I didn't mispronounce you too badly, guys, for that, coming up on their 10 years. So good stuff. All right, let's move on. Tonight's episode is brought to you in part by cache-advance.com for all your geocaching needs. Cache-advance.com, go find it.
And also by coinsandpins.com, the best place to get custom coins, geocoins, lapel pins, and patches made. Go through our GeoSnippets links and use the promo code HeadHardHat for a 10% discount. And FYI for our listeners, you can sign up for their newsletter to get notified of when new coins and patches are available for sale.
All right.
We're also very thankful to all of our sponsors. And if you want to see more of their products, be sure to go to our GeoSnippets websites and simply click on their logos. Not only do you get great deals, but it helps our program as well. And FYI, as he mentioned, we're putting together some special all-month-long contests with our sponsors for October, November, and December. And we'll be giving you all of those details very soon.
Okay, coming up. Let's move on from there. Okay, I'm going to do my yeehaw in a second. It looks like we're having some technical difficulties.
Yep.
For the people in the chat room, can you hear us at all? Is it just a picture that is frozen? And then basically with that, if you would, if you can hear us, just refresh your screens. From the
no sound or video.
Okay, so something has gone busted on the main video there, and there's no way for us to correct that right now that we have without restarting the whole thing.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is we're going to continue on with the podcast, and we will go from there. There's no way for me to refresh it or whatever. We're going live as we are right now. And as far as I can tell, we're recording live as well. And we're recording the podcast as well. So, for the technical difficulties out there, but there's something on, Google Hangouts that's causing this, and there's nothing that we can do with it. So we're going to continue on with the show as if we were just doing it straight through. And again, we apologize to the people from the video end of it. If that is messed up, it's going to be messed up all the way across the board. And the only thing that's going to be able to go out with this will be the podcast itself. So we're just going to continue straight through.
What about prizes?
We will do that next week if that's the case. So we will do that. Let's jump right into the Geocaching Printables GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast, episode 129. And yeah, we had a lot of really good stuff that went along with this. One of the most popular things that happens when it comes to people requesting information off of my blog. And in case you didn't know, if you go and find Geocache, I'm Not Obsessed, Right? That is my geocaching blog that I've had since 2008. And it's literally a smorgasbord of all the different things, all the different geocaching travels that I've had, all the bits of information, all the insights that I've had. And that has acquired as almost a database now of geocaching information. Through that, people request certain pages of information more than others. So what that is what's that?
Memphis Mafia said they could all go home. He just won the coin.
Well, there you go. So what happens is one of the most most frequently asked things that come across through that is things like, I want to make my own geocaching logs so that way I can have backups when I go out geocaching and I can have these extra logs out there available. How do I do this? Where do I even look to get those? So that's what we're going to talk about tonight, are different geocaching printables and so many things that you may not have even thought of that you can actually go out on the internet, find and print out for yourselves. So tonight, one of the ones that I wanted to show you right off the bat, and I'm hoping the video is still going, even though it may not be transmitting out to everybody live, hopefully it's still doing it through YouTube. If not, I'm just going to do the podcast and we'll talk through it anyways. One of the ones that I have, and I actually have a spot in my blog, and we'll leave a link for it in the show notes. And it is a quick breakdown of literally printing out, cutting out, getting prepared, and packaging different sets of logs of different sizes. And if you go to this link, it's actually going to bring it up. And I'm going to bring it up on the screen here. And hopefully that will work for me to do this. Let's see if it's even there. There we go. So I'm going to bring this up, and I'm going to share it. And like I said, if this doesn't show out in the actual video, I apologize, but we'll still talk about it because it's still visually you're able to see what's going on with it. So let me bring it up here.
We've got all our show notes.
And we've got all our show notes. So right here we have, let's see, where is it? There we go. All right, so this is my actual screen that I have showing how to actually print off your own geocaching log sheets. Now, there are several places that you can go off to do this. And with that, you can actually go out, figure out the different sizes that you want to print, and then print them out. So the first picture that comes up literally is that. It is literally showing how to go to here, figure out, for this one, it was different sizes for 35 millimeters. And you can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different log sheets that are in here. It prints it out. I usually print out maybe 2 or 3 at a time mm-hmm. that you'll staple together. Mm-hmm. And then you basically, what you do is you just go through and you cut all the way across and you cut out the individual logs. And I'll show the next picture of what that looks like. Mm-hmm. So this is them separated. So all the outside stuff's gone. They're into individual log sheets. There's like I said, two or three deep for each. I don't think you for logs you're going to want more than two, three sheets anyways when it comes to that. And you can always put out more if need be. And then after that, you fold them up. And that's what this particular picture is showing. You just fold them in half and fold them in half again. And the reason why you want that size is that you can go out and get the jewelry bags. Now, these jewelry bags can be found usually at most of your craft store areas. And they come in different thicknesses. I highly recommend the thicker the package of the plastic, the better. The longer they last when they're out, when you're actually doing your geocaches, so these come out, they get exposed to the environment, even though we're in the geocache containers, and you go in, you just get the thicker plastic so that they last longer, and also they can be opened and closed longer that way more times. So the thicker, the better. And again, you can get them at any particular craft store that you go to.
They're usually pretty cheap, too.
They're pretty cheap. Yeah, they really are. And here I'm showing three different sizes. The bigger ones that I have that I printed out here are mainly made for small geocaches.
Mm. Somebody said they found those in at flea markets in the tools area.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, good spot.
Yeah.
Wherever you can get them, it's awesome.
Yeah.
The next one is the ones that I use for the 35 millimeters. Mm-hmm. And the final ones that I have up towards top, I use for nanos. So those work out real well. And basically, the one thing that I didn't mention that I highly recommend you do, if you're going to have two or three sheets together for a logbook, staple it so that it keeps them together. That just helps out in the long run. But that's basically it. I mean, there's not a whole lot to it. Let me get through here. It's pretty easy, and you know what I do is I take a, for example, what I'm showing right here on the screen now is I go through, and I get a quart size bag. I print out a bunch of these, and I just keep this in my backpack, and then that way, because you do eventually run out of them. Some sizes tend to go a little quicker than others. And they're just handy to have. They're nice. The bigger ones are handy for, like I said, for the small or the regular size logbook to get them by. Mm-hmm. They're really kind of nice. And this whole bag of quart size that I've got here, there's probably, I don't know, maybe 100 different sets of logs here. That took like 3 hours to go through and put together. So we will have the links in the show notes where you can go to print off the individual logs, and you just do that. Take the extra initiative to go out and make your own set, because I guarantee you're going to come up to the geocaches that need log replacement. So that's how that one goes. Pretty cool. Good stuff.
Sure.
All right, let's move on. The actual log books themselves, not only is in the blog post that I have, we also going to have in the show notes two different areas that you can go to and print out all the different type of logs that you want. And matter of fact, I'll show you what that looks like right here. Let me get out of here. And
we are periodically showing back up.
We're periodically.
Yeah.
Thank you, Google Hangouts. I'm sure that's
somebody will say, "Hey, I'm back."
And then, I'm down again. And again, that's nothing on our end. This is all going through
Google Plus. And it's all different ones. So somebody will say, "Oh, I'm back." And everybody's like, "Well, I'm not." Or somebody will say, "I got sound." I don't.
Oh, wow. What a mess.
Yeah, it's funny.
All right. But the podcast itself will come out
great.
Yeah,
they're still there. So they're hanging in.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So this is some of the stuff that are out there. You can get different types of log sheets that are in color or black and white, different columns for different sizes. Just tons and tons of stuff out there that you can get. And again, these will all be in our show notes when it comes to stuff like that. Another popular thing that people don't even think about are stash notes. Now, stash notes are neat. This one we got off of Landsharks out of Canada. And what this is, let's see if I can actually get that to come up. Okay. So here's where the downloads are for them. Stash notes are those little bits of information that tell exactly what a geocache is. Mm-hmm. These are just as important as the logbooks to have in a geocache container. Now, granted, the teeny tiny logs, you're not going to be able to see much.
Right.
Because they're so small.
Right.
But even the 35 millimeter containers, they have information in here to say, hey, this is a game piece.
Right.
Don't take this. This is part of a game. If you're interested, go to geocaching.com, that kind of stuff. So stash notes are very important to have also in your different type of geocaching logs and geocaches themselves. The next one that I think is just as important as anything else when you go out geocaching, especially if you run into a muggle, are brochures. Mm-hmm. You can print them out in color. You can print them out in black and white. The point is, if a police officer comes up to you and says, "What you doing?" You can have, now I usually try to have at least 10 or 15 of these in my pouch or my backpack.
There's a Geocacher University?
Yes, there is. Out of Geocacher University, which is an actual website.
I had no idea.
They've got a ton of things. And again, this will be in the show notes. Emergency logbooks. You can actually print out a whole page and turn it into a complete, fold it just right to turn it into an emergency logbook for larger geocaches. But the other part that they have in here is the actual the logbooks themselves, where you can go to and print them out. So those information's in there. And I'll bring this up. So it's got all the different ones. This is how it makes an actual, what you would do for what I would consider as a regular geocache size. Mm-hmm. A little bigger, a little more heavy duty, and it takes one page to fold it up.
Oh, that's nice.
So I thought that was really, really sweet. They also have a whole list of the smaller ones as well. Mm-hmm. So if I go to like this one here, which is another resource, this will actually show you the different log sizes before you, there we go. This is the brochure. So what will happen is you print this out and it's actually literally just says, "Let's go geocaching." And this is a threefold piece of paper that you print on both sides. And away you go. You print it, you fold it into three, and you have a brochure. So that way when the police officer comes up and says, "What you doing?" Or if you're going up to a, let's say, an area and the landowner is there and you want to tell them about, you want to hide a geocache, you actually have a tangible piece of paper in your hand. It doesn't look like you're just making it up and you know, out of your head. You've actually got a piece of paper explaining what geocaching is. And this one in particular has really, really good information about geocaching that you can do. And like I said, I try to keep at least 10 of these in my pack, because you'll constantly come up to people that'll say, "Hey, what you doing? What's geocaching? What have you?" And there you go. You got an actual bit of information explaining the whole game, sport, and obsession. Mm-hmm. So that's really cool. Brochures, very, very important. This I always thought was awesome.
Oh, for kids.
Geocaching journals for kids.
Yes.
Kids like to write down, "What did I do today?"
They do?
They do.
I never did.
You take them out.
But I'm weird.
Most kids. Most kids that are out there. They go through and they like writing a little geocaching journal. It gives them stuff to do in between geocaches. So what they do is you can print out these little journals, and it literally says things like, "My geocaching journal has a little kid's name."
Aww.
Little geocaching log spot in there, so you can actually go through and see, you know, the name, the date, the cache name, all that information, so that they can see the different things of what they're doing and going that way. So it's neat. There's a lot of stuff that you can go through and just make out for the kids. It's a couple of pages. They can write things
what they
like,
saw, what yeah, they heard.
Yep, they're different. The locations, the time, the temperature, the different sights and sounds and all the notes that are into that. It's just a couple pages. And then Homegrown Hearts Academy is the one that actually put this out and gave
that's really some cute information. I like that.
This is neat. You print off about four, five, six pages of these. You do one of the main page, six of the geocaching logs, and the little bits of observation. And the kids got stuff to do in between doing geocaches. So I thought that was really neat for geocaching logs for kids. All right, let's see. Other fun stuff. Now, printable labels. There are tons. Again, this is different types of logbooks and labels that you can do. This is a neat site that has different versions of the logs that you can print. Everybody has their own style on how they want to do it. This one, and again, we'll have it in the show notes. But you can print off your own larger geocaching labels to put inside and outside the cache to print that out. I would probably put this more inside because if you're just going to print it out on paper, it's not going to last too long in the weather. But if you put it inside the lid, they tend to last a little bit better that way as well. So those will always be cool. This I thought was really kind of neat. And it's literally a thanks for the cache card that you can print off. It looks like a little business card. And in there, it just sits there and says, found your hiding place. Thank you for stashing this little treasure here. Thank you for helping us with geocaching. Thanks for the cache. And it has where you can sign your name in that.
Oh, that's neat. I like that.
Just a little way of saying thanks for hiding your geocache. So I think that's awesome to be able to do stuff like that.
Yeah, that's cute.
And again, in the show notes that you'll have for places for people to do this. Now, another one that we had.
Ooh, ring decoders.
This is something that I was surprised. Now, I actually
have. See, that sounds like an 80s thing.
Yes. I actually have a very large, in one of my cases here, I have from the caching place, a large brass made decoder ring. It has an inner ring and an outer ring.
Hang on a second.
Uh-huh.
The website for the cash card was KITNKAI.com/logbooks.
Right. And it's under printable labels when it'll be on the show
in notes. It'll be in the show notes. But if you want to look it up right now, it's KITNKAI.com/logbooks.html.
Awesome. Good stuff.
So they were asking.
No problem.
Why y'all have audio? Absolutely.
The ring decoders. Now, Caching Place for many years made a what I would would consider is the creme de la creme of geocoins as an actual decoder. It's awesome. I have one myself. They're fantastic. I went looking for it today, and Caching Place is not there anymore. They must have went out of business, which is a shame because they made a really, really good quality product. But you could still make your decoder rigs. And you're saying, well, why make a decoder rig? Because you can do ciphers with it. And the one that we have here in our show notes actually has what they refer to from the code talkers, from the Navajo code talkers. And what I'm not sure if it's actually legit or not, but they actually talk a lot about them. And they show how you can make your own cipher wheel. And actually, you can make your own codes using this decoder ring. So this is really cool. This is great for kids. This is great for puzzles. It's great for puzzle caches. All you have to do is have a template that they can download so they can make the matching code ring, and you make yourself with all the different codes that you want to do. So I thought those were really cool. Amy, you might as well, it's a lost cause. Just let her go.
I know.
All right. So decoder rings are cool. And again, part of the printables you can do as well. Morse code sheets, again, another thing that you can have for geocaching, for parties, for puzzle caches. It's a simple sheet that you can go through and print off, and it literally has all the different things when it comes from the Morse code and how you can go through and take those and turn those into the actual, you know, whatever you want to use for your puzzle. GCC, the geocaching calculator, is also awesome for figuring out Morse code and ciphers and the decoder ring stuff as well, depending on how they match up. So again, other printables that you can use for different geocaching events, parties, what have you. All right. The other one that I thought was awesome, and you're starting to see these more now, they kind of faded out for a little while, and now they're back, is vehicle placards. And basically what these are printable pieces of paper. I actually laminated mine because I used it so much, that literally says, "Hi, I'm a geocacher. Please do not tow this vehicle. I am out geocaching, and I will be back soon." And you had, there's actually a spot on there where you can write down the time that you left and all the rest of that.
Did you laminate yours?
I laminated mine.
You have one of those?
Yes, I do. It's in my glove box. Oh. So basically what you do is you take that.
Until I don't rummage through your glove box.
That's it. You can actually hang it from your rearview mirror, or you can put it on your driver's side of your window and just hang it there. So that way, if the police come up or somebody comes up and it's like, you know, whose car is this, this kind of thing, it lets them know that you're a geocacher and that you're out geocaching and you will be back soon. So I think those are awesome and saves some people a lot of grief when it comes to things like that. All right. And I think we only got the Muggle cards. I love these. And again, this is from Land Sharks. I absolutely love this. If you are out geocaching and you don't have the full blown brochures that you want to give to somebody, these Muggle cards are awesome. And they can go through, and basically what it does, and for some reason my screen's taking a little longer than it should to load. It's almost there. What'll happen is, there we go, it's a printable sheet.
Oh, that's pretty.
And you print them off, and it literally tells in your elevator speech of what geocaching is. So that if you don't, and it's in business card size, which makes it awesome. So that way, all you have to do is, if somebody says, you know, what's geocaching, you don't have a lot of time, you don't have a brochure, you give them a Muggle card. And it gives them all the information on where they can go and what they can want to do to actually see what geocaching is. And again, you can make, what, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 of these on a single sheet of paper. I'd laminate them or print them off on a business card stock so it's a little more heavy duty. And just have it in your geocaching pack. And when the question arises, there you go. And away you can keep on caching, and the person can still get information about geocaching itself. So Muggle cards are awesome. The last little tidbit that we've got for tonight is, and I love this, and I wish they would come back.
Oh, that's nice.
This is first to find certificates.
Aww.
So basically what happens is, before, way back in the old day, it was very common to have first to find prizes. Uh-huh. And they could range from anything, you know, from people. It's just literally that. It's like prizes for our show. You could win a geocoin. You can win a bunch of different things. At the very least, I think what would be cool, and I've done this with some of my geocaches, is you print off a first to find certificate that says you're the first to find finder. You know, here's the geocache name. Talks about it. You know, it says it's entitled to all bragging rights with privileges recognized by the geocaching community, signed by the geocache owner. And you fold that up and you, or you laminate it and you put it in the geocache for the first to find prize. I think that's kind of a cool thing. Not much to it. There's no major expense.
No.
And it's neat.
Yeah.
So again.
And imagine the, you know, the little kids would like to find
kids,
something like
adults.
That. I'm sorry.
I'm just saying, first to find. Come on, Nanner, Nanner.
I just want to get the first to find.
I get it. You don't, Nanner. So I'm just saying, we'd be arguing for the certificate on the way home. I can hear it already. I found it. No, I found it.
No, I just want to sign it first, right?
I'm just saying.
You can have the certificate.
Oh, I see. As long as you actually get the first divine,
yes,
it's cool.
Yes.
I see.
Yeah.
Wow. And so you see how that goes. Wow.
Yep.
All right.
As long as I actually get it, you can have the certificate.
Oh, gee, thanks.
You're welcome.
You were just a heart of gold. Anyway, so that's geocaching.
Every dog for himself with his first of five, baby. I'm telling you.
So that's what we've got on geocaching printables. There's a lot of other things that you can look out into the interwebs and find that you can print off and do different fascinating and fun things for, like I said, geocaching events, geocaching parties, geocaches themselves. Just have a good time with it. It's great. And a lot of things like the logs and the brochures help the geocaching community as well. So keep that in mind when you're out geocaching. All right. Good stuff. Let's move on.
Your support helps keep all of the GeoSnippits Reboot shows running along. Please consider making a PayPal donation through the link on our website to support our efforts and your ongoing entertainment. From all of us at GeoSnippits, we thank you.
Absolutely, and please, please, please consider becoming a patron for our show, for the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast universe, because this is your show. If you get any information when Google isn't bombing out on the Hangouts, or we're not having technical difficulties, or any of the other obstructions that happen when it comes to putting out a podcast, when we actually have stuff coming out to you and you can understand it and you get any kind of value, please, please, please consider going over and clicking on through either geosnippets.com, geosnippetsreboot.com, click on the sponsor me on Patreon, click that, and literally for a buck a week, you can give more. But for a buck a week, if you click on that, you can, for the length of time that you do it, you can become eligible for different sets of prizes. And it's anything from the patron pre-show in audio form, our hangouts. We have our GeoSnippits path tag, Patreon path tag. We've got another item coming out very shortly when it comes to patches. I mean, we've got tons of stuff that we can do, different rewards, and they're all nested. So in other words, the longer you participate, the more rewards you get. And it's also great for contests. Patrons get that extra little nudge that maybe an extra entry for a contest or for patrons only, that type of thing. There's a lot of rewards for a buck a week. Go over, click on that sponsor me on a Patreon icon, go in, fill out for you want. And again, if you can give more than a dollar, awesome. Thank you so much. And for all the patrons out there that are literally help keeping the lights on for the show, thank you so much. It is greatly appreciated. All right. Good, good stuff. Let's move on. All righty, now time for the GeoSnippits Geocaching Cash Stash. Man, that was professional. Let me explain what this is.
I don't know why I expect less.
Some of the best geocaching companies in the world. And they, quite frankly, want to tell you fine folks about their products and services. So to do that, what they do is they go and they send us some of these products, and we turn them into prizes, and we give them out each and every week. We spotlight the company. We spotlight the prize. They win because you find folks hear about it. You win because you get to win them. So that's how that works. That's a geocaching cash stash. Now, for last week's show, Wife Amy, was episode 128. What was the prize?
The prize was from GX Proxy. And it's a goodie bag.
Yes,
including
ma'am.
A bison, black bison tube, a trek tag, geocaching pennant, whistle, green carabiner, and some key straps.
There is a bunch of stuff in here. This is a very cool bag full of goodies, and we love giving them out. And we want to say thank you to gxproxy.com for providing all those goodies. What was the question for last week?
The question was, who is considered the father of the geocoin? And the answer is Mountain bike.
Mountain bike. That's right. And actually, I'm going to give a plug for Podcacher. I learned a lot. If you listen to last week's episode, so it was from literally last week for Podcacher, go to podcacher.com. Check out their episode. They talk with Mountain Bike. They actually go out with him, finding some of the oldest geocaches in Idaho, I think it was, and a lot of history about what Mountain Bike went through when it came to inventing the first trackable geocoin. So that's, like I said, Podcacher. Go check them out with Sunny, Sandy, and Sean. All right, so now we have the answers here. Let me show you how this works. What we do is we total up all the correct answers, and I'm going to put that in here because this moved it. There we go. And it goes from one to the total number of correct answers that we received for episode 128. We also have, as we do this, our emails, which are coming up, and this actually has all the emails right then and there. So wife Amy is going to flip her magic coin, hopefully not dropping it.
I have to move my microphone.
And she's going to figure out if it's heads or tails. Now, say, for example, the number that came up in the random number generator was 4. It was not 4. But if it was and she picked heads, we would count from the top of the list of emails down 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and that would be the winner. If it was tails, we would count up from the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, and that would be a winner. Just adds a little bit of randomness to the actual solution of who wins the prize for the week. Wife Amy, are we going heads down or tails up?
Heads.
All right, heads down, which is relatively easy because, let me count down here. All right, so we had for that, and let me make sure this is correct. All right, now we have, guess who won?
Who?
Geopudge.
No, he didn't.
No kidding.
Did he really?
Yeah, Geopudge.
That's
fine. Yep, congratulations. Perry is actually his first name, Geopudge. And congratulations, you are the winner.
That's funny.
Hey, you know, what takes all. That's great. That's awesome. Congratulations to Geopudge. You won that grab bag from GX Proxy of all those goodies. So way to go. Fantastic. Hey, that's how it works sometimes.
Yeah.
All right.
Very
so
cool.
So you're saying to yourself, wait a minute. How do I win all these cool things? They give away great swag. They give away geocoins. They give away good stuff. How do I win this stuff? Well, it's very simple. To become eligible to win a prize from the Cash Dash, all correct answers must be in by, for this week's show, 12 noon Eastern Time, Wednesday, September 23rd. That's next Wednesday, 2015. I'm going to set this up on here so that you have in the bottom thoid. All you have to do is send it to gsreboot@gmail.com, subject line Q1, episode 129. So gsreboot, G-S-R-E-B-O-O-T, @gmail.com, subject Q1, episode 129. Wife Amy, let's see, all correct answers will be put in a drawing just like you saw.
Don't bring me in early.
Some weeks for the people in the live chat room. When video is working like it's supposed to, this will be interesting tonight. We will have a second prize.
Well, I think, here's what I think.
All right.
I think we should push it out till next week.
Because not everybody's there.
Because the video is not working. The audio is not working. They don't even know what we're talking about right now.
Okay.
So I don't think it's fair. And I think to be fair to everybody that we should wait.
The wife has spoken. Hear ye, hear ye. So, all right. The prize.
I would love to give it away as a prize.
But I don't think it's fair.
I don't think it's fair.
So, what we will do is we will give away the prize that we were going to give away live tonight.
We'll give it away next week.
We will give it away next week because it's only fair.
Yep.
It's not our fault. It's not your fault.
Nope.
It's just Google Hangouts doing whatever.
I blame Google.
So, yes.
I blame Dave.
We will do it next week. But we can tell them about what we are doing for this week's episode. for question number 129?
Yes. Yes, right. We can.
Why don't
so
we
they can
that?
Go ahead and get their answers in.
Right.
Yes.
So go
absolutely.
For
the How to Puzzle Cache book by Scully Long.
Right. When you if you go back a couple
it's
episodes.
It's not Scully. It's Cully.
Did I put Scully?
Yes.
It's Cully.
Yes.
Basically, if you go back a couple of weeks, we had Cully on to – that's just a mistype in our show notes. We had Cully Long on for talking about his How to Puzzle Cache book. And he said, hey, for one of the prizes, we will give that away. And that's what we're going to do this week for prize for episode 129. It works the same way. Just send it to gsreboot@gmail.com, subject Q1, episode 129. And we will, you know, send in your answer to the following question, and we will do that. So, Wife Amy, why don't you tell them the question for this week?
All right. The question is, what types of characters would Rot 18 use? What types of characters does Rot 18 use?
We've heard of Rot 13. We could even hear of Rot 10. What type of characters is used for Rot 18? ROT18, Rot 18. Send your answers in to gsreboot@gmail.com, subject Q1, episode 129 for next week, and you have a chance of winning the How to Puzzle Cache book by Cully Long. So I am going to fix this real quick because that was a misprint, and we will go from there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, like I said, the live prize that we were going to do tonight, because we don't know how many people are actually able to get any part of the video, audio, or whatever tonight, thanks to Google Hangouts. So we will move that.
They don't even have a clue we're even talking about it. So
we will do that.
They're talking about alligators
next week. All right. All we can do now is wrap this puppy up.
Yep.
Well, folks, thank you so much for stopping on by. We hope you enjoyed this episode. I know the audio will be fine. The video, probably not so much. But please, 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 we hope you enjoyed it. Let us know what you think about tonight's episode, and we will strive to do more. And tell us other suggestions. What would you like to have as topics on the GeoSnippits Reboot podcast? And we will consider that and actually make episodes out of that. We don't want to make this one-sided where we just kind of guess. We'd love hearing from you fine folks and going from there. So please, please, please let us know, and we'll go from there. Finally, please become a patron, a contributing factor of the GeoSnippets Reboot podcast universe. Without you folks, we just plain couldn't do it. So please consider becoming a patron. Send us a couple of bucks each week and keep this podcast going. We greatly appreciate it. Finally, tell other geocachers about our show. We love seeing the GeoSnippets Reboot podcast expand all over the place. So just let them know. Let geocachers know about us so they can come in and get in on all the geocaching goods insights each and every week, just like you do. All right, Miss Amy, if you'd close us out, please.
All right. Want to thank our sponsors, CashAdvance.com and CoinsAndPins.com. Want to thank Andy HeadHardHat Smith and thank everyone watching in the chat room. Please keep those comments coming in, and we'll see y'all next time.
Yep, I'm going to say a special thanks to Wife Amy. We've got some interesting shows coming in. Something for you to consider. One of the show topics that we wanted to do coming up is things you have to explain to others about geocaching. Either, you know, muggles or your family or the police. Any of that type of stuff. What are some of the examples that you have to explain to somebody about geocaching? And we'll total all those up and make a complete show out of that.
Well, I already have one.
I'm just saying. So please let us know and send that to gsreboot@gmail.com as well. And we'd greatly appreciate your insights for that. It should be a lot of fun. All righty. Good stuff. See you next week. on the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast at Thursdays at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time for another episode of the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast. And as we like to say in the GeoSnippits studios here in North Kakalaki, see you out on the trails, folks. Bye-bye. Please be sure to join us each and every Thursday at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time for another episode of the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast right here on the GeoSnippits website at www.geosnippets.com. The video version of our show is available on YouTube, and the audio version is available on iTunes, Stitcher, Blueberry, the Tech Podcast Network, and many of your favorite podcatchers. We love hearing from our viewers and listeners, so please leave your feedback by emailing us at gsreboot@gmail.com. Visit us through our social media sites, or contact us via our voicemail line at 919-341-9519, or use our website Send Voicemail tab. GeoSnippits Reboot is a HeadHardHat production and is produced by Amy and Andy Smith. This show is copyright 2015 by Andrew T. Smith. All rights reserved. And clear. All right. For the people, if you can see anything or hear anything through the video, I have no idea how that's going to turn out for the video this week from Google Plus. Obviously, the information that's going from us to what we can see on Google Plus on our end is perfectly clear. So we have no idea where the mess up is. Again, like I said, for Gearheads, they were having a lot of problems last week as well. So we're not quite sure what's going on with it. I'm thinking it's going to probably, if you guys couldn't see the video that well, that none of this is going to matter anyways. You're not going to be able to see anything anyways. If anything, just consider to please go listen to us via the audio part. That should be fine because that is literally recorded here. So that should be fine, and we should have everything go that way. Sorry for the inconvenience for stuff. When we'll make up next week. We got a lot of good announcements coming to you your way as well. So have a safe one. Be good out there. Have fun geocaching, and we will see you next week on the GeoSnippits Reboot Podcast. Bye-bye, folks.